Well, greetings, greetings. Welcome to 2022 Empowerment Prayer Series. This is a new year, and I want to take this opportunity to wish you a very happy, prosperous, blessed, wonderful new year. And we want to speak God's blessings over you and your family before we end this session on tonight. And this is a new series. We started in December with the Christmas focus on who Jesus is. And I've been inspired or led to continue this series, except more in depth. We are going to talk about who is Jesus? Jesus, who is he? From Genesis to Revelation. So, because throughout the entire Bible, Jesus is revealed from Genesis to Revelation. And in this setting that we're starting on today, January 3rd, 2022, we want to see Jesus as the seed of the woman. And you'll find this in Genesis chapter 2, verses 4 through chapter 3, verse 24. And so, briefly, just a little summary. God the Creator, he completed or finished his masterpiece. And that was by creating man and woman, male and female. And he breathed life, or he breathed a spirit into his special handiwork, his prize creation. And although sin entered the world because of man's disobedience, we will see that God provided for the redemption of mankind, all mankind. And the command was in Genesis 2, verses 16 and 17, the word of God says, "And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die." Now, they didn't die physically immediately. Their bodies continued to function, but their hearts were hardened. There was this spiritual separation because remember, God had walked with them and talked with them in the garden, so they had relationship with him. They had friendship with him. And that's what died. Their relationship with God was severed when they disobeyed God's command. But the good news is, hallelujah, the good news is God provided for redemption from sin. We'll find this in Genesis, the third chapter, verse 15. This is the prophetic word. This is the prophecy of the coming Messiah. He says, "I will put enmity between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." Jesus is the seed of the woman. He will bruise, he will be bruised, but he would utterly crush and eternally defeat Satan. The bruising that he received would be temporary, his dying on the cross, but with his resurrection from the dead, Satan would no longer have the power over anyone who received Jesus Christ by faith. It may be a hard thing to comprehend with our finite minds. So therefore, it requires faith to believe that Jesus is the Messiah. He is the Son of the living God. And this prophecy was fulfilled. We'll read about it in the New Testament, in the Gospels. And so Jesus, in Genesis, he is the seed of the woman, not the man. Now, we know that woman does not have seed. It is the man that has the seed. But because she was impregnated, hallelujah, by the power of the Holy Spirit, yes, God the Holy Spirit. And therefore, Jesus is the seed that was prophesied in Genesis there. And so, as we go through this entire Bible, we want to take a look at Jesus. Who is he? From Genesis to Revelation. And we want to cover this in this series as we enter into this new year, 2022. And then after we present, give a little insight, identify who he is in each of these books, then we are going to pray. And tonight, we're just grateful. We're thankful because we know without a shadow of a doubt that this prophecy was fulfilled. How do we know it? Because we experience it. We have received Jesus Christ by faith. He is in our hearts. We have relationship with him. We are friends of his. We obey him. He speaks to us. And so we know that this prophecy made in Genesis that God would provide redemption for us. We know it to be true because we have been redeemed, hallelujah, by the blood of the Lamb. And so we are grateful on tonight. Once again, thank you all for joining, those that have come in. We bless God for you on tonight. When I sent out the notice, I know it was short notice, but at this point, in this time, in this hour, we have to be about God's business and what he instructs us to do. We cannot any longer procrastinate. We have to do it. We have to obey. And in these settings, I don't plan to be long, but I would like to give opportunity for anyone that comes on, any participants, to share, to have comments if you would like. Again, our first session, as we go through the entire Bible, we're looking at Jesus. Who is he? From Genesis to Revelation. And tonight we begin in Genesis, and that is Jesus is the seed of the woman. We find this again in Genesis, the second chapter, verses 4 through the third chapter, verse 24. Thank you for joining, Sister Duty. You have any comments would you like to share at this time? It is being recorded.
I'm sorry, I was late for the phone. No, not at this time.
Okay, all right. Well, thank you so much for joining. We won't be long, but we're just beginning this new series, and we're looking at the revelation of who Jesus is throughout the Bible. And tonight we begin with Genesis, and he is the seed of the woman. And we can be so grateful and so thankful for what God has provided for us. So let's just pray. Father God, we just thank you so very much. We give you all praise, honor, and glory because of who you are. You're worthy of praise. You're worthy of glory. We esteem you. We celebrate you. We appreciate you. We thank you, Father, for what you have done for us. We see in the Word, as we begin this series in Genesis, that Jesus, hallelujah, is the seed. He is the promised Messiah. After Adam and Eve's disobedience, you already had a plan. Glory to God. From the foundation of the world, your plan was already made. and you knew that they would disobey you. But we thank you, Father, that your plan is still in effect, a plan of salvation, that anyone that will believe in your Son, Jesus the Christ, would come to him and be redeemed. He paid the price for us. We thank you so very much. We give you all praise, honor, and glory. Thank you that you have redeemed us. Thank you that you have reconciled us to yourself because of our faith in Jesus Christ. We thank you. And yet, Father, we pray for those who have not received you. We pray for those who don't know that your plan of redemption, your plan of salvation is for them. So we pray on tonight as we continue through this series, book after book and Monday after Monday. Our prayer is that someone will hear and know and find out, go in search and pursue for themselves the truth of who Jesus is. Glory to God. I pray that their eyes are open, their ears are open to hear. Anyone that will hear this in the days to come, Father, I pray that your Spirit would draw them, that they will be drawn to you, that they will search the Scripture, that they will look for themselves, not just take my word for it, but they will get in the word for themselves and seek and search. For in them, hallelujah, for in your word, there is life. Life that comes through faith in Jesus Christ. Father, we pray today for families, for sons and daughters who don't know you, who are wandering aimlessly, that don't recognize who you are and the great plan that you have for their life, that you have purposed before the foundation of the world. We pray, Lord God, hallelujah, that their eyes are open, that they are drawn to you, that they will cry out, you are my God, hallelujah. And they will cry out, what must I do to be saved? And it is a simple gospel. Believe in your heart, confess with your mouth that Jesus is the Christ. He is the Son of the living God, that he died on the cross, hallelujah, and he was resurrected by the Father, glory to God, on the third day, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father, that place of honor with the Father, hallelujah, in glory. Thank you, Jesus. And he is forever making intercession for us. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise, honor, and glory. We bless you. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that this no longer be normal as usual. This is a new year, and you have a plan, and you have a purpose, Father, for our lives and the assignments and the lives that we are to touch. I pray that we don't miss any assignments. I pray that your purpose for our lives come to fruition. Let us not be fearful and worried about what others will say or think, but let us be fearless and unstoppable, knowing that you are with us, you are for us, hallelujah, and no weapon that is formed against us will prosper. Father, we thank you so very much. You are so good. You're merciful. You're faithful. Your loving kindness is better than life. There is none like you. Glory to God. And we worship you on tonight. We give you all the praise, honor, and glory. We thank you for the word that you send to us day in and day out. We thank you that you commune with us, that we can have fellowship with you, that you speak to us. And we pray, continue to speak to us. Continue to help us to understand and get the mysteries of your word, the truth of your word. Enlighten us, Father, we pray. We just want you. We want you, more of you. And all that you have for us, we say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We pray, Father, for the peace that only you can give. Not as the world gives, but the peace that comes from you, from being in relationship with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. It is a peace that we cannot comprehend with our finite minds, but we know it to be true. We know it to be so because you give us peace. I know that there will be challenges in this new year, but help us. Help us to be resolute in that we know that you are with us, and the peace that you give, we receive it in the days to come. Whatever challenges we may face, help us, remind us that you are with us. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Remind us of your word. Glory to God, that we know that all things work together for good to them that love you and are the called according to your purpose. We thank you that you chose us. We thank you that you chose us. We did not choose you, but you chose us. Thank you, Father. Thank you for Jesus being the seed of the woman in Genesis. And that you fulfill that prophecy when he was born to the virgin, lived, walked the earth for 33 years, and returned to glory. Help us open our eyes that as we go through these books in the Bible, open our eyes and reveal to us with greater understanding of who Jesus is. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for everything that you have done and everything that's already done, that we wait for the manifestation. Hallelujah. Our expectation is of you, great and mighty God. Wonderful is your name. We bless you on tonight. Father, I pray for those that are listening, those that are tuning in, that will hear in the days to come. I pray and I speak blessings in their homes, over their family in this new year. That you will meet every need, every concern that they may have. You perfect, you complete. Their lives are complete in you. I thank you, Father, that there is no lack for those who are in Christ. Their life is hidden in Christ. We are complete in Christ. Jesus, high everything. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Bless them, I pray. Let there be healing in their bodies. Hallelujah. Wherever there's sickness and disease, you are God, the healer. Glory to God. I ask, Father, that your healing streams flow, that the blood of Jesus continue. Cover them. Cover their homes in the mighty name of Jesus. Preserve their going out and their coming in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We give you all praise, honor, and glory. It is in the matchless name of Jesus the Christ that we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, praise God. These are just short sessions as we go through the Bible and look at who Jesus is in each book of the Bible. And again, we thank you so very much for joining, for listening on tonight. And have a blessed week. And remember, hallelujah, Jesus is our enough. Hallelujah. God bless you.